Let's bring in our good friend, Adam Schefter. And Adam, you have some news, right?
Well, we've been waiting on a decision tonight about whether Teddy Bridgewater is playing Michael and Don. And the latest is this. A short time ago, the Vikings just signed Chandler Harnish, a quarterback off their practice squad, onto their active roster. Now, ordinarily, we say, why is that significant? It wouldn't be. But in this particular case, with the questions being about Teddy Bridgewater's ankle, they wouldn't have signed a quarterback off their practice squad if they felt Teddy Bridgewater was fully capable of playing and starting tonight. So now they have an added quarterback, which tells you that I think, again, they're saying game time decision, nothing official, but my read into this is that Christian Ponder winds up starting tonight. Chandler Harnish winds up backing him up. Maybe they have Teddy Bridgewater in uniform, maybe not. But clearly they would not have made the move with Harnish were things not completely okay with Teddy Bridgewater. So the news is that they signed Chandler Harnish, a quarterback, off their practice squad, and I think that has direct impact on tonight's game.
Yeah, I think that's the right way to read it, and it just doesn't seem like it's an injury that he is going to be at his full effectiveness anyway, and you're going up against a really good football team tonight. That's a tough situation. Made a little bit of news earlier this week, Adam, with your report that there are people within the Jets organization upset they left so much money under the salary cap. Of course, the Jets deny that, but we've talked about it before. He's very patient. You've said this is a win-now league. Don't read into the future. He's just a very patient person. But isn't patience also someone that's probably a little bit more focused on 2015? That's an awful lot of money to leave under the cap in a year where maybe your head coach needs to make the playoffs to save his job.
Look, I believe that John Nizek is focused on doing what's best for the Jets, short and long-term together, okay? And if there's a move to be made, he's going to make it. The issue that I think some people have a problem with is that you've got a guy like Dominique Rodgers-Cromartie in your building, and you let him go across town and wind up signing with the Giants when you need help at that position. You make an inquiry into DeSean Jackson when the Redskins are well into it. You get into the game late. You're very careful and conservative on all these things. And again, that's not a wrong or bad way to build a team, but there are some people who it certainly – they've noticed it, and I don't think they're overly pleased about it. That I can tell you for sure. And they look at that number, $21.2 million under the salary cap, and they say, what are we saving that for? We want to win now. We have needs at the cornerback position, the wide receiver position, the pass rusher, return game. We need guys. And then you can say, okay, well, what about the draft? The Jets entered the draft with 12 draft picks, the most in the league. And right now, of those 12 draft picks, five are on the active roster. And so they did get some immediate help, and there are some players that look like they have a chance to be some very good players, but it's still 5 of 12 with the fourth-round pick Jalen Saunders being cut this week.
Now, organization's kind of a broad term. Does that also include players? Have you heard that players are upset about it as well?
I'm just going to say, generally speaking, I don't think the players pay as much attention to it as other people in the organization, okay? I think the players are more focused on doing their jobs, but you know, the people that are on the organization, they want to see the team operating at its full functioning level. And I think that they just feel like there was more that could have been done. Now, again, some people say, and I've had people point this out, John Nizek's doing this the right way. And he's building a team the way it should be built, slowly, patiently, methodically. But that flies in the face of what some other people are expecting. And, you know, fans want results now, and they want that money spent. And they want all the moves that can be made to win today. They don't really care as much about long-term. And so when you see some of the moves that the Jets could have made and didn't make, I think that's what has people feeling a little bit disenchanted.
Now, Adam, we had Woody Johnson on. It was a couple of years ago, and he surprised me with a comment. He said, $1 billion invested in a football team is a really bad investment. He said, you don't get the return that everybody thinks you do. So do you think that he's behind them not wanting to spend money? He just doesn't want to throw that kind of money at a football player?
Well, first of all, if the Buffalo Bills go for $1.4 billion, I don't think Woody Johnson's investment was a bad investment at all. I'd love to get that kind of return on my money. But it's a situation where, to me, it's hard to imagine that Woody said, you know, I'm going to hold back the cash. I mean, that's not been the way that they've operated in the past, right? I mean, he's given them the resources that they've needed. And it's hard to imagine when owners these days, NFL owners are pretty flush in cash, that he's going to say, hey, let's pull in the reins on this right now. I just think, you know, John Nizek was being the way that he is. John's a very smart, intelligent man. And he's very methodical and careful okay. about how he does everything, including his free agent business.
And I got about a minute. So if you show patience, and it does come at the expense of a team maybe finishing 7-9, 8-8, and missing the playoffs, would that be fair then to fire Rex Ryan?
Again, I come back to my point initially that it's a win-now league, that everybody's judged on a year-to-year basis. And I've said to you all along, I thought the GM was as much on the hot seat as the head coach. Okay. I don't think this is just a purely head coach issue. I think this affects everybody. And the owner must decide what's best for his organization. And again, I think Woody and Rex are pretty close.
Good stuff, Adam. As always, talk to you soon.
Thanks, guys. Have a great one.